Today I will show you an easy and cheap way of starting with SDR radio. Ready-made SD card images for a Raspberry Pi with all the needed software installed and pre-configured. Ready to work with most SDR receivers like the RTL-SDR dongles or the Adalm Pluto. And I will show you a cheap alternative to the RTL-SDR dongles. Finally, I will show you the cheapest and simplest way to generate test signals for our experiments. Hello, wireless enthusiasts! Here is the channel with a strange Swiss distortion in the signal, with a new video around wireless and other exciting stuff. Make sure you subscribe if you do not want to miss the following emissions. If you are interested in how software-defined radio works, I strongly suggest watching my video about the topic. Today, I assume you know how it works and want to play with it efficiently. We need two main components to receive signals using SDR technology. A computer to decode I and Q signals generated by analog-to-digital converters, usually placed in a separate box. Computers usually are Windows PCs or Raspberry Pis. Typical SDR frontends used in amateur radio are the SDR dongle or the Adalm Pluto. The Pluto is also capable of transmitting, by the way. The connection between the PC and the SDR is USB. The better the SDR front end, the more data it generates. RTL-SDR dongles, as well as the Pluto, still use USB 2 because they can process only bandwidth of 2, respective 20 MHz. My professional Spectron V6 needs 2 fast USB 3 lines in parallel because it can process 245 MHz in parallel. Anyway, the Raspberry Pi does not have much power, and often you cannot use the whole bandwidth of the SDR frontends. Still, this combination is practical and fun to play and learn with. The third thing we need is software. Fortunately, many specialized packages exist. Their names are SDR Sharp, SDR Console, or GQRX. All of them create a waterfall diagram and can decode the usual modulations. The next class is Universal Radio Hacker, RTL-433, or in Spectrum. They are used to hack and decode unknown signals. I use such software to hack and clone my garage door opener, hack tire pressure sensors and use them to brew beer, and decode the signals of my proprietary weather station. You find links to all these videos in the description below. The next class consists of packages to decode specialized modulations, like slow scan television from satellites or AC/ARS signals emitted by planes. The last category is software to support experiments. The most famous is GNU Radio Companion. It offers Lego-like boxes that enable building sophisticated radio systems or experimenting with wireless systems. These software packages have one in common. They are not easy to install and need a lot of prerequisites and drivers. An average person loses too much time before he can start to play. And if you are not a Linux guy, you often have to give up before you start. For our SDR introduction class, I searched for a simpler method and, with the help of colleagues, found three possibilities. Luigi's Pi SDR Image Project, Ryan's Radio Conda Project, and cemaxecuter's DragonOS. All projects can be used on Raspberries, and all promise to run out of the box. Because a lot of data has to be managed, I strongly suggest using a Pi 4 for SDR experiments if you do not have a dedicated application in mind. For this video, I will concentrate on the Pi SDR image. It has an extensive software stack and uses Raspberry OS. Its newest version supports 64-bit, which increases the speed of SDR applications. The following steps are based on the work of another Andreas, HB9HDF, and Nicole, HB3XUY. With this project, we have a head start. We download the SD image file and use Raspberry Pi Imager to burn it on an SD card of at least 16 GB. If you plan to connect via Wi-Fi, fill in Settings and select Use Custom. Then select the file with the name pisdr, choose the target SD card and hit Write and a few times Yes. Grab a beer and come back when the SD card is ready. Now you can boot your Raspberry. We need a display and a keyboard mouse because most programs run with a graphical user interface. You can run it with VNC from another PC if you know how. Before you continue, you need to run volk_profile in a terminal window. You are lucky if you did not drink the whole beer before, because this step again takes some time. Volk, by the way, means Vector Optimized Library of Kernels and selects the fastest kernels for a particular computer. So it optimizes the speed of our Raspi for GNU Radio. Now we are ready to rumble. I already inserted one of my RTL-SDR dongles, a deluxe model. Of course, you can also use cheaper plastic dongles. This telescopic antenna is handy for experiments because you can adapt it to the wavelength and after experimenting, it fits in a drawer. To test the setup, I select GQRX and hit Execute. Then I select the RTL-SDR dongle, hit OK and select 434 MHz. If I key up my RT85 on 434, we see its signal. So everything works. Cool. Let's now try one of the more sophisticated packages, GNU Radio Companion. With this tool, we can create all sorts of RF designs. I built a simple one, a frequency display. It consists of two blocks, an interface to the dongle and a display block that displays the frequency and a waterfall. Also, this one works. So these pre-installed packages seem to work. Let's now try another SDR frontend. Here I have an interesting competitor to the RTL-SDR dongle, the MSI2500. It uses the chips used in the first SDR play generation and has 5 different SMA connectors. Why 5 inputs? Each connector has a filter for a particular frequency range. Cheap SDRs easily overload by strong signals on very different frequencies. This concept helps a little to avoid such overloading. In addition, this board has a 14-bit ADC and, therefore, a much higher dynamic range than the 8-bit dongles. And it has a 10 MHz sampling rate, 5 times more than the dongles. This enables the use of wider bands. So let's check if the integration works. I discovered that it is not advisable to plug and unplug the SDR frontends when the Pi runs, by the way. It blocked or crashed several times. After changing, we can select the MSI2500 and it works with GQRX. Also, GNU Radio Companion has a block for this module. It is called RSA1. So we have another cheap possibility to play with SDR. It is still advisable to buy the original SDR play boxes if you want to use them for real applications, because they are more sophisticated. Still, for a learner, these small and cheap boards are ideal. Fortunately, Andreas, HB9HDF, also checked the Adalm Pluto, the SDR Play RSP2 Pro, and the Hack RF1. All worked. So we can also build transmitters using a Pluto or a Hack RF1. But what about the promised cheap transmitter for simple test signals? We must add these two lines to the boot config.txt and reboot the Pi. We just start rpitx and start easytest.sh. This marvelous software creates all kind of signals on pin 7 of the Raspberry Pi. Let's connect a wire to this pin and start a narrowband FM signal on 434 MHz. And really, we hear a broadcast done by the Pi. How cool is that?
Testing whether that nation or any nation so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure.
I'm pretty sure that the two lines must be removed when you are done with RPITX. I do not have to tell you that you are not allowed to play with this program if you are not a licensed ham operator, and that you have to prevent harmonics if you add a longer antenna. I'm in the basement and the signals do not travel more than a few centimeters. One word to the second project mentioned before, DragonOS based on Ubuntu. I tried it too, and it worked very well. Its creator has a YouTube channel where he uses SDR technology to the max. DragonOS and cemaxecuter's channel are a must for the nerds amongst us. The rest is probably more comfortable with the Raspberry OS and pisdr image. That was all for today. I wish you a lot of fun experimenting with SDRs. It was never so easy. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. 73 to everybody, and please consider supporting the channel by using the links in the description. See you in the next episode.